this morning. It was a privilege to be here. Holy Spirit, we want to thank you for the presence. Direct every word of the mouth.
Yes.
Lord, let every flesh in me die this morning.
Amen.
Let your word come with revelation.
Amen.
Let your word come with power.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We pray all your hearts here to hear your word.
Amen.
And to understand what you are saying.
Amen.
Thank you, precious God.
Thank you.
Jesus, mighty name we pray.
Amen.
A young lady was doing his father's prayer. And she went and invited some dignitaries to grace the occasion. And there was this wealthy man that she went to invite. And the wealthy man came with his entourage. And she entertained the man. The man drank. The man eat. The man did not spray any penny. And the man left the place. While others were just talking, the man just talked with all he got, with all his followers. He just left that spray bottle. The girl didn't say a word. They get paused and they listen to everybody. After 3 days, the little girl, the young girl, or a lady went to this man's house with a bottle of wine. I went there and kneeled before the man. I said, thank you for your presence in my father's burial. She did not complain and she did not listen to what others were saying. She knew that before the man and said, thank you for your presence during my father's burial. And the man received the wine, and as the girl was about to go, he called the girl at the gate and said, come. Say, I thought you would complain that I came in and go without spraying water. It means you have a heart of appreciation. The man said, wait. The man went inside the house and wrote a check of a very good amount of money. The money you would not have sprayed in the burial, and he gave it to her. And again, left it. Of appreciation. Power of appreciation. Luke chapter number 17, verse 11 down to verse 19, or thereabout. The Bible talk about Jesus was going through a certain place and he met ten lepers. In fact, he was going through Samaria to Galilee, and the Bible says he met ten lepers. And the Bible says that he was far from these lepers, but the lepers could cry from afar, could shout from afar. That's all of God. Mercy on us. And the Bible says, Jesus came and said to them, go and show yourself. Go and show yourself. And the Bible says, as they went, they were dead. As they went to show themselves. And the Bible says, they were cleansed of the disease called leper. They were cleansed of the disease called leper. Said, we are not free to join our people in a society. Jesus, I'm not enjoying myself with this woman. We were at an outcast before. Let me go and appreciate this man. And the Bible says he came back. He came back to Jesus. He knelt before the master and said, thank you for what you have done for me. Who is it? The new woman. Before now, I was a castaway. I can't join my people to do anything because I was a leper. Leper does not join other people to do anything. See, but now, by your message, you have united me with my family and to my people. And Jesus asked a very simple question. I know you were not alone that day. Do we ever take of you? Where are the other nine? There are people who don't know how to say thank you when you do anything for them. And these people, they will lack helpers. They will lack favor. Because even the little one you have done before for them, they refuse to say thank you. Show to them the little appreciation, the little time that you are giving up to them. They refuse to say thank you. And don't worry, I'm always saying. I didn't hear you, I'm always saying. I'm always saying. Even me, if I am by any means, God used me to do anything for you. You didn't tell me to say thank you. I will not talk, but it will be in my heart. Then another time, you will need my help. I will pay a deaf ear if I see my not here. Am I talking about? Tell someone, say, let us say thank you. Say to somebody, they say, let us show appreciation. Thanksgiving is the expression of gratitude, especially to God. Thanksgiving, expression of gratitude. I want to thank God. Mind this morning when the Lord will push me to that happen. Don't be surprised that anytime they stand before God to do anything for God, God will empower them, strengthen them by all means. What? The first one God did for them, they were able to show appreciation to God. Appreciation will not be there. May the Lord help us in Jesus' name. Amen. Did you hear me? I said, may the Lord help us in Jesus' name. Amen. In heaven, then, the Bible says the man know that his condition was seen like this before. The condition was something else. But a man changed his condition. A man made him to be equal with his mate. And he said, this man deserved to be thanked. This man deserved to be thanked. For me, I thank God for His grace of my life. A man of God went to preach somewhere, and as he was preaching, people thought he's just exercising gifts. Lie down. They talk about this man. also examples of what he's trying to do. They waited and waited until Matthew 4 rolled out of his hand before they know that it's beyond recognition. It's beyond man understanding. Before the pastors and the elders of the church rush the pastors on the altar, it's already gone. But here is God's time on the altar for 10 years. Here is Mama on the altar for 10 years. Here is you. Where did God pick you from? Then where and how have you been able to show God appreciation?
I don't know how other people will preach it. That is for me.
or come and say, or went away of him. The Bible says, he that is faithful in little is what? Is faithful in much. If the church or the pastor can give you 10,000 naira and say, to your business, and you cannot say thank you, and you cannot advertise what the Lord has done for you through the pastor, you only see bad, you only see error, you only see mistake of the pastor, you are not qualified for the next level. That is just that. You won't qualify for the next level. I will allow you to qualify for the next level, except you change. Even the Bible says God himself is a jealous God. He's a jealous God. I was not too surprised for the miracle the Lord has done for Pastor Friday. Many will still call. I said many will still call. The Bible says he that humbled himself with what? Will be exalted. He that humbled himself will be exalted. I am not the one that will exalt them, but the God who called you, the God who I serve, will also exalt them. But if you thought that you are the one, and the scripture says that servant is no greater than the master. That is just the genesis of what it's all. Many and many miracles of surprises has been for me. That is if you humble yourself. But the many can't humble because the spirit in them will not allow them to humble to go to the next level. Many cannot be broken down because pride in them have already said they will not go to the next level because of that pride become. And there are many people, when God is about to bless them, they make silly mistakes that make not to frown. When God is about to lift them up, they make mistakes either to the man of God or to the church or to God himself that will make them to remain in one place. My prayer for you this morning, wherever you are watching me from and wherever you are hearing me from, every mistake that you will make that will make God to turn back against you, may the Lord deliver you from it. If your amen is loud, the person I'm talking to. Psalm 107, verse 21 and 22. Psalm 107, 21 and 22. Oh, that men should praise the Lord for his goodness and for his wonderful works. Local government chairman, not even state, PFM chairman, And somebody was talking to him, and the phone of the person rang. I saw the person switch off the phone in the presence of the chairman. That is a sign of respect. He didn't tell chairman, wait, excuse me, let me pick up.
He said, no, you would have said,
wait after service, I will call. Say, because of that, say you are not qualified, you are not a role Christian. Even though they give you this contract, you can also steal and do false. That was how you missed it. And we were able to tell the man, oh God, please, so let it be after service. As far you are using flight, bread, things of the world. The women were doing their confession. You can't follow one mouth in the house. You can't follow one mouth in the house. And they say that the pillar of the church, every one of them is money. And the Bible says in Matthew 6:33, seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, then every other thing will follow. Church, can I talk to you? The mistake that people are making is that they don't acknowledge who God is. That God can do everything for them. They thought that it's by the power. Lord, can I talk to you? Church, it is not by power, it's by grace and favor.
Receiving, you will be there.
It is written. to ask, no food, they will give you food. It's good to ask, no water, they will give you. But at the time, challenge yourself and say, no, Lord, it is time for me to stop asking. Lord, check my stomach. Take my stomach until you fight for what you want, you won't get it. Do you ever say again?
Yes, sir.
I remember when Friday and family came to the church. When Friday and family came to the church, I remember. I didn't preach to them. Mr. Friday called me and said, Daddy, I saw you in a dream. That was my thing. I said, what do you mean? He said, I saw you. I still remember the way she told me that dream. He said, I saw you in a dream. He said, they were in a pit. She was in a pit somewhere. He said, I was just coming and he saw me and he shouted and I lifted her out of the pit. He said, she woke up. And he said, I will look for God's time. I think we have only met that time once or twice. I will not be a pastor. I mean, Daddy. When they came to church, I know where they were. But today, we are dedicating a brand new car. That is first level. Because where they have gone, where God is taking them, where they God is taking them to, your eyes, your mouth cannot even see it. That is where you humble yourself and tell God, give me grace to humble. It is those who are humble that can benefit, not those who are proud. May you not be paid. I think a few days after this person. Am I talking now?
Yes,
but when you are saying who is God's time, where did he go to Bible school here? Where did the man of God, when did they establish the man of God? I want to hear what he talk. Not be the one where they don't be the talk. You want to call the show money, they do it here, they show the money, they do it here. I don't know whether you are supposed to be show money. I didn't know whether it's you that's supposed to be show money. Huh? Or my normal value in your name. Because I don't want to hear me normal value. I didn't hear your amen. Praise God. Psalm 9 verse 1. I praise thee, O Lord, with my whole heart. I shall show forth all thy marvelous work. I will praise thee with my whole heart. I shall show forth all thy marvelous work. All thy marvelous work. Has God been faithful to you? When I see Mr. Abimelech and I smile, I say, God, I thank you. And many of you here, when I see you now, I say, God, I thank you. God, glad to have you. The Lord is changing lives. Some time ago, when I sat down, I said, something told me, what of any church should not grow? And we have up to like 20 cars. Where will you park? I said, it's that place now. Spirit of God was just speaking to me. I see some holy church and I said, I'm going to wait for way grass for some very one part. The thing you tell me, I went to the man who felt that they said, by this time next day, don't move from there, they want to use the one car. Nobody understand. Are you seeing it now?
Yes, sir.
Your car space is there.
Yeah.
Your car space is there.
Yeah.
Your car space is there. Praise thee, O Lord, with my whole heart, and I will show forth all the marvelous work. Psalm 106:1. Praise ye the Lord, and give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, for his mercies endure forever. Psalm 100:4. Enter his gate with thanksgiving, and into his court with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name. Verse 5. For the Lord is good and his mercy is everlasting and his fault and his truth endureth all generation. The Lord is good. If every one of us want to evangelize, every sitting down, want to show God's love and evangelize the truth, this church in 2 months will not be enough. You know why? You know how? Thank you, sir. You know how? When you go out, I didn't tell you to go and preach. I didn't tell you to go and preach to the people. Jesus loves you. Just go there and tell the person how good is your church. Tell the person how careful or how disciplined is your pastor and how good is your choir. That's enough. So it's only enough to resource. Don't just tell your truth. You see your neighbor pass. You begin to clap hands and shake your neighbor. And unbelievers are around looking at you. Two brothers in the same church will be in the same house. They will be fighting each other. Two neighbors in the same house. Maybe different flag. They will be fighting each other. Ooh, you don't know what you're doing yourself. Ooh, and how do you expect believers? How do you expect those that you are preaching to follow in your church? Because character can drove them away. Matthew 5:16. I want to read Matthew 5:16.
Problem and adding to their own.
Am I teaching?
Yes, sir.
Is it good?
Yes, sir.
If you don't know good, take care of that. So I wish you can learn for what I'm saying now. So people will leave their own problem. We leave their children problem. We leave their family problem. They will come up with that mask on and put it on their head. And we got to discuss another people's issue. Discuss another family issue. We will not see that man. You know something God do day that day for job. Don't just see that woman. Don't she will just you will just keep us the owner of the world. Your own. They put limits. Did they draw limit? Did they draw line on it? No. Tell somebody say, check your heart. Tell somebody say, check your heart too. I wish to put it better. Thanks to the beast, the ability to worship God with your tangible substance as an act of appreciation to God. Check out Psalm 24:4. John chapter 11 and verse 2. I will read for NLT. NLT version. This is the Mary who's later poured the expensive perfume. Expensive perfume on the Lord's feet and wiped them with her head. Brother Lazarus was sick. Expensive perfume. We are talking about thanksgiving. We are talking about appreciation. Out of every 10 people, it takes 2 or 1% to do thanksgiving unto God genuinely from the heart. The Bible says that perfume, because of that perfume after that time, will be able to buy, to build a home for offerings. Because of the perfume alone, if they sell out the amount, you will reach the new house where the offerings put. The Bible says, when Judas Iscariot saw the perfume, and he said to himself, "What is what for that waste product? They don't have waste the perfume. Therefore, sell out, and they would have sold it and used the heart and use the money to help offerings, to help those who are poor." And Jesus turned back and rebuked him. The poor you will always have with you, but this one, leave it for me. Since then, you don't see this kind of expensive thing. If I, this one, you don't come anoint me now for life. But this is the last anointing I will receive while on earth. And he told the woman, keep the perfume and use it to anoint my baby body. Read the Bible. So that was why Mary Magdalene kept the perfume. It was Mary Magdalene who first saw Jesus when he rose up. And he told the man, the angel, I said, please, so show me where you take the master's body to so that I can go and carry it. He had perfume where he made that time. That he kept where he wanted to anoint his dead body as God promised. So as Jesus told her, and Jesus told him, I said, you see this woman? This thing he has done, anywhere the gospel will be preached, her name will be mentioned. Thanksgiving can put you in a place of remembrance in God's heart every day. Can I stop here? I think I will stop here. You are not talking, no. Shall we start about it? So, when they are coming for Thanksgiving, they begin to wave the gift they are bringing to God. They begin to wave the things they want to give to God. If we bring out 7 yam under the pen, if we still bring the 3 waste small parts, come give God. We say bring all the 7, and they come out all the 7. We say this one is good for my head, keep this one. This one, a good for Panama. This one, I'm okay. This one, good. This one, okay. Now, this one, can I go? This one, waiting for Panama, paper, his house. And the Lord deliver us from the church. Open right now. If you be willing to open your heart, appreciate God for for the gift of life. Thank you for opportunity to live. Thank you for I am not among those that are surviving with oxygen. Thank you for I am not among those that are needed right now. You get to the hospital now. Those who are happy are happy, and those who are crying are crying. Same.